Hello everyone and welcome back to another edition of MC Marky Mark video. I'm on the MC Magic server. Right behind me is Cinderella's Castle. We'll be touring around not the Magic Kingdom, not Epcot, not Hollywood, not Animal Kingdom, but Hollywood Studios on its 25th anniversary, the big 2-5. So let's travel over to Disney's Hollywood Studios and start our adventures. I'll only be covering those attractions that were there on opening day back in 1989. Let me travel over to Hollywood Studios. Some of the Disney's Hollywood Studios music in the background. I hope you can hear it. The MC Magic server uses audio packs and the resource packs. Combines magical moments from Disney in great fashions that they can do with Minecraft and MC Magic does in particular. And I'm not using any servers, you just download the resource packs from their website mcmagic.us and you can get to do anything. You can listen to music, you can tour the theme park, you can see almost anything. This is the Hollywood Studios entrance. You go through the turnstiles, you get tickets right here. 4 days for $239, 1 day for $83. I believe that is correct. Because I know at Magic Kingdom it costs a little bit more. It costs $99 for 1 day pass. Let's continue through the turnstiles. These aren't actually here anymore. They're the My Magic Plus bands that would be right here. But that was there actually in 1989, you'd be walking through these turnstiles. Over here, you'd have the wonderful, what is it called? Crossroads of the World. I should know that, but that's the Crossroads of the World. Mickey on top, sitting on a globe. This Crossroads of the World comes from, actually, from Hollywood. But it's not, it's just a replica. It's not actually from Hollywood, it's a replica from Hollywood. And here, over here, we'd have some, I believe this is the souvenir stop and all that. I think this used to be owned by, not owned by, was sponsored by Kodak. Over here, you have customer relations or guest relations. Over there, you have wheelchair at that tan building. You have wheelchair, and over here, you'd have like quick service, like get like popcorn and all that over there and over here. You have lockers, strollers, and wheelchairs at Oscar's gas station. Bathrooms over here, as usual. There's bathrooms almost 15 steps you walk, and there's a bathroom. This is a dark room. This is where you can get photographs. This used to be sponsored by Kodak, but no longer. Buy a brick to get a camera. And as always, in the Disney fashion, you just walk through each and every store or shop or whatever. I forget what this was. I know one of them is souvenir shops. This is a souvenir shop. So many souvenir shops, but that's how Disney makes their money. And with ticket prices, Disney's making their money. Let's continue down this way. Another souvenir shop. Mickey's of Hollywood, another souvenir shop, I think, yes it is. Souvenir shops, and it would end here. No Sunset Bay, Sunset Boulevard. Over here you have a map. Loading very slowly. I know the theme park, but like the back of my hand anyway, so. Don't know what the shops are called, but I know like, over here would have Hollywood Studios, but we shouldn't be walking down this way, because it did not exist back in 1989. Map is still loading. Continue off this way. Over here, you just have some shop. Let me see my video settings. It is render distance, turn up to 13. You can't see the hat just yet. Now it starts appearing. That hat was not there in 1989, so I can't do anything about it except ignore it. But the Great Movie Ride was the star attraction. Unfortunately, due to lead law and some bad stuff that happened with Disney and the Grumman Chinese Theater, they can't use that as their opening, so they had to cover it up with the big hat. I enjoy the hat. A lot of people don't, but that's fine for me. I've heard rumors that they're going to move it. No rumors have come true, so let's just sit there and cover up this beautiful Grumman Chinese Theater. Let's ride the attraction, because this is the attraction that I find my favorite. It's the Great Movie Ride. Continue through here. QQQ. You see some memorabilia from different movies, shows. And here you'd see some of the old classics. Alien, Indiana Jones, Mary Poppins, Fantasmic, just to name a few. The ride is open if these doors are open. Hopefully it is on. Okay, the light is on. Is off. Someone is already on the ride. Okay, wipe my hand. Hold on. F1. There we go. Yay. I'll talk some through. This is a nice opening thing. I think they might be using chat, if I'm not mistaken. Might be using text. I don't know. Is it going to move? No, I guess not. I guess they're not going to use text. Hello everyone and welcome to the Great Movie Ride. Once again, my name is GMR Fan, and I'll be taking you from this hollow soundstage into the middle of the action of the greatest films ever made, all on one tour. But just between you and me, this is not any ordinary tour. Sorry, that text isn't showing in there. If you walk, I can't read that, that's too fast. Here's some of my favorite. Let's visit some of those great Hollywood musicals, starting with the 1933 Bubbles in Brooklyn extravaganza, Footlight Parade, starring James Cagney, Ruby Keel, and Dick Powell. In 1952, Gene Kelly was singing therein. Did you know Gene Kelly co-directed this movie? Can anyone tell me what this movie is? That's right, it's Walt Disney's Academy Award-winning film, 1964, starring Julie Andrews and Dick Van Dyke, Mary Poppins. That's one hot L right over here. I don't think this is beautiful. This looks like a world from the underworld of such classic gangster films as The Public Enemy, starring one of my favorite tough guys, Jimmy Cagney. That's, is that them? Nah, just a rubber tech, no, a bunch of rubber necking tourists. Psst, hey you, I'm talking to you. This car's about to get out of here, so beat it. Here they come, boss. Get you out your grinders. Oh, God. We're getting shot at. Muggsy, they got squid. Muggsy. Sorry, boys. I'll make my getaway. Give my regards to the warden, suckers. Hey, what are you looking at? Everybody, mind your P's and Q's, and nobody will get hurt.
And now, the Old West, and two of Hollywood's legendary stars, Clint Eastwood and John Wayne.
The only film that they made together. Believe it or not, Clint Eastwood is still alive. I think, I don't want to quote myself, but I think John Wayne is passed away. But if, I shouldn't say anything, so. There's a rank rover. There he is. Don't let it get away. Hey, I don't even work this neighborhood, Kappa. This is nuts. And nuts to this. I'm getting out of here. Look at it this way. Things can't get any worse. Okay, it's worse. I don't know about you guys, but this is kind of creepy. What is this?
This is Alien. You're with Sigourney Weaver aboard the spaceship Nostromo. Something has gone wrong. The crew has vanished. And somewhere in the ship, a terrifying creature waits to claim its next victim.
Emergency distress system is now activated. Where's the alien? Oh god, the alien's appearing. We should get out of here. This is kind of bad. There he is again. Enough creepy crawling thing for one day, right? Wrong.
Here in Raiders of the Lost Ark, amid 1,000 deadly snakes, Indiana Jones are thirst at a great discovery. Will Harrison Ford escape the discovery? And what will be your fate? Beware.
Snakes. Why did it have to be snakes? Wow, look at that chunk of ice. Time to get back to work. Don't even move while I go get the goods. See, I don't think they noticed a few extra bodies around here, you know what I mean. Halt, unbeliever, distribute the treasure of your god and you shall all pay with your lives. This is way too fast. The text. Normally the attraction would be a little bit slower. But give or take, it's Minecraft. I see dead people. The horror film is my favorite time genre. Some of the best horror films are made in the 1930s and 40s. However, the monsters we're doing today, I can't even say that. We're now entering the jungle home of one of my favorite movie stars. What the? Most memorable movies of all time. No, it's not Return of the Jungle. It's actually Tarzan, portrayed by Johnny Walsmo. Over there, we have Maureen O'Sullivan as Jane and her lovely and talented cheetah as herself. Whew! I can't say that fast. Normally, this attraction would be a lot slower. Louis, I think this is the beginning of a beautiful friendship. The best last lines of a movie ever. Humphrey Bogart and Ingrid Bergman. Classic romance, Casablanca. He's one of my favorite movie stars, Mickey Mouse, and one of the greatest roles, The Sorcerer's Apprentice and Fantasia. The sorcerer's name in this sequence is named Yen Sid, which is Disney, spelled backwards. Soda, I have a feeling that we're not in Kansas anymore. How often do you get to say that? I definitely say we are somewhere over the rainbow in one of the most beloved movies of all time, The Wizard of Oz. No music in the background. Eh. It's off to see the wizard. Who killed my sister? Who killed the wickedest of these? Was it you? I'll buy my time. Just stay out of my way and you will argue. Follow the yellow brick road. Follow the yellow brick road. Follow the yellow brick road. Gonna stop singing there. Over there we have some of our favorite stars. Dorothy, Tin Man, the Scarecrow, and the Lion. Cowardly Lion, but the Lion. And now we can watch some films that weren't shown in here, but not in the first Blue Sky or the first artifacts of it. Would just be some things that was supposed to be an ending that would just give like a bow to almost anything you saw in the back of the attraction. But unfortunately, due to probably money constraints and everything, it had to be shortened to just show the films. But I bet you if they had the time now, they would redo it. Unfortunately, some of the things, it won't ever be redone. But that's it of the Great Movie Ride. I said eat some food. Okay. I think I'm hungry even more. Well, let's exit the attraction. That was a lovely Great Movie Ride, my favorite attraction of all time. If you can understand GMR fan, Great Movie Ride. Over here we have the ABC Commissary, American Idol Experience, which was not there since American Idol is just, I think, 10 years old, give or take. But before that, I think it was it was like a filming attraction. We can make commercials and stuff. Fake commercials, but it was commercials anyway. I'll take a tour back here. And then we'll go on to the back lot tours. I don't think it would be that long if the Great Movie Ride was that short, so. Over here we have Science Fun Dining Theater. Lovely, lovely restaurant. Watch some of the very classic scary films. Kind of funny in our times, but you would eat some delicious peanut butter and jelly sandwiches, hamburgers, smoothies I think they're most known for. Let's continue this way. That's the back of the New York City skyline. But you would actually go down near Streets of America, or New York Streets, is what they called in the beginning. Muppet Vision 3D, this area was not even here. And over there, Star Tours wasn't open on opening day, but it was there. What is this? Looks like one of the doors, but I think it's for Haunted Mansion. But over here was not even here. This part of the area was brand new, like the early 90s. So let's just continue down this way, because I'll just show you some of what we like to call where the tram used to come through. The tram used to be like, I think like an hour or something. That it was very long, since it used to go down Residential Street, which is not longer here since Lights, Camera, Action took it over. But this is San Francisco Street. Over there is New York Avenue. And this is all over here is called Streets of America, is what they call it now. And in the early, I think the early 90s or late 90s, they put lights around here for Christmas. Very awesome. I'd recommend to anyone, if they're in Disney during the holidays, check it out. Am I still hungry? I'm hungry. Over here we have the Honey, I Shrunk the Audience. I'm trying to think if this was here. I don't remember. But over here, that's a restaurant over there. Some awesome memorabilia we can get over here. There's a thing of Funicello. She was a original Mickey Mouse Club member. This over here is Lights, Motor, Action Extreme Stunt Show, which was not here at the time. It was Residential Street. So a lot of Hollywood Studios has changed over the past 25 years. And it probably continued to change. As Walt Disney said, if there's imagination in the world, everything will continue to change for the good or for the bad. If you think that Residential Street being taken over by Lights, Camera, Action is bad, then it's bad. Is this open? Let me check. I think it might be. Let me see. Backlot Tours. Let's try to check out the Backlot Tours. We'll ride two attractions, this one and the Great Mood Ride, which we already did, since these were the two major attractions at the time of opening of Disney's Hollywood Studios, just about a year, not a year, a year ago, yeah. 25 years ago. This has changed over the years, but it's still similar. It's like a action sequence of Pearl Harbor. Guests can take part in it. You just have to be, I think, 16 years or older. So ask one of the cast members, they will guide you through it. I was one of them. I was in the calling area where you just have to pick up a phone, then get drenched. Hey, person. Hello, Ada. I can't say that name. Okay, now we have to go down this way. Hey, you just hopped over. That's the bathrooms. This is the entrance. This is a prop area workshop where you can see many props from different attractions. Can I cut through? No, I can't. I'm not gonna cut through. Just walk through the normal queue. Whoa! What's down there? Walk through here. What the? Okay. Yeah, Stitch knows where to go. Never mind. I can hop on. Hop on. There you go. Okay, we're gonna move. There we go. The wonderful Earfall Tower over to the left. We're gonna switch. Whoa! Switching tracks. I don't know if they're gonna. We include recording studios, sound stages, high tech, editing rooms, all the tools that needed in the TV shows and radio broadcasts. We've even got our own water tower. Earfall Tower. Our water tower stands at lucky 13 stories high, and we've added our own creative touch, a giant set of Mickey ears. Yes, it is called Earfall Tower. That's why there's Mickey ears on it. I don't think there's any water in there, actually. Don't catch me wrong, but there's no water in it. It's sad, but one of the, on the right of the aircraft, 2001 blockbuster hit Pearl Harbor. The exact scale replicas of P-40 fighters were used in a special effect fight sequence. Of course, many of the planes you saw flying through the air or sitting on the ground weren't actually real at all. They were created entirely within a computer. Sure, ruin the magic, but they weren't actually real. They were created inside a scientific computer. We're entering one of our most glamorous and comical departments, creative costuming. Every star needs to have just the right wardrobe, and it all begins here. Grammar. Oh, cat is the dirt. Why did I think that was Grammar for a second? Going through. Some costumes off to the left. What you would see in Disney. What is that? Flashing light. On the left is our scening shop where the giant sets and props are built. They all provide sets and props for our shows at Disney World. Some of the parades and everything you see could have been created here. Either way, it's all about making magic. Making dreams come true, not magic. Making dreams and magic come true. Riding to. Another talking bit coming up. I guess not. What happened? I don't know what that was for. It caught me off guard. Over here we have some of another replica. This is a... Now we're entering a zone called the Boneyard. It's a storage area for oversized props and vehicles. We often see these props in case we need them for future use. And over here we have Lights, Murder, Action, Extreme Stunt Show. So get out your pictures, because it's a wonderful set. We're now passing by our Lights, Murder, Action, Extreme Stunt Show. On the left, you may catch a glimpse of the finishing villages that sets stage for the amazing adventure. And that's what we call. Off to our right is one of the largest sets on our backlot. It might not look like much, but it's pretty spectacular from the other side. Yeah, it is actually spectacular from the other side, because it's a wonderful set that they have at Disney. Over there we have NVM 230, I think. Remember Mickey Mouse 2030 or 230? We'll check it out when we get out of this wonderful set. But that was the... This is great. The production crew has just given us clearance to enter the set. Hello, everyone. I'm End, one of the Imagineers here at MC Magic. I can see your shuttle heading towards our canyon set. We're getting ready. It's a little bit to do a test sequence. A little bit of redstone issues. Whoa. I guess I can't see, so. You can chest if you can, and see one, take two, action. Fire. Uh-oh. Water coming down. And cut. Good going, everyone. Great scene. I think there's... Okay, there we go. There we go. Many of our shows at MC Magic use the same technique, and this is one is no exception. Most of the explosions are custom designed fireworks redirected by floating blocks. Unlike the real Disney studios, we use pistons and water source blocks for our flooding. However, the real Disney Hollywood studios, all pumps would be right here. Ooh, this is all that they have to do to use everything. The giant redstone block repeaters in front of us is the center of the floodgate. Control that contains over 400. Everything is else color coded. Red is floodgates, orange is explosions, lapis is the water, and so on. Oh my god, though it may look complex, catastrophe can use mostly a bunch of timers. You can probably do it on your own in single player. Entire sequence is less than 2 minutes and it runs 576 consecutive with outcast member maintenance. Well, I've got to meet the next gym, so I'll see you guys later. Some of it was over here is the 1964 news plane, the Flower Project. Later purchased the land that Walt Disney World Resort is built on. NVM364, I think. November Mickey Mouse 64 something. I know if it's MVMM. November Mickey Mouse. Once again, on to your right is the Villages from the Lights and More Action. This attraction is based on the similar at Disneyland Paris. Yes, it is based off the one at Disneyland Paris. It was originally built in Disneyland Paris, then came over here to just claim land. Hopefully let people see it. It is a big show in the beginning, but it's starting to die down with the crowds. The staging area off to our right is the Acceleration Alley. Here the custom-built vehicles rev their engines up to 70 miles per hour before making their speed entrances onto this stage. On left, we've reached the second boneyard with more historic props and vehicles. I don't remember what this one is. There's a Herbie, there's one from Star Wars. Wonderful attractions. Not wonderful attractions, wonderful props. Excuse me. Keep freezing on me. The redstone work. On the right is a very different view of the fishing villages. As you can see, there are insides of the buildings, excuse me. And it's very... And it's very great how Disney does it. Oh my god. He's invisible. change at night. Over here, we'll start seeing New York City. The skyline of New York City off in the distance. Really can't see it in the rear distance. Here's a backlight we can avoid filming because we have our own Varmer. Our Streets of America facade can stand in for a small town or a great giant metropolis. Metropolitan area. And there you have it. We've almost reached our end of the tour. At our final stop, you can see some of our costumes and movie props. Thank you for joining us and enjoy the rest of your stay here at Disney's Hollywood Studios. Justin Bieber, best villain ever. That I gotta say, Justin Bieber, best villain ever. It's kind of funny. I'm sorry. My apologies to anyone who likes Justin Bieber. Sleepy Hollow's Headless Horseman. Dustin Hoffman as Captain Hook and Hook. Greatest villains in all times. ABC Once Upon a Time. So it is a lot like the Hollywood Studios. You walk through you always have to walk through this American Film Studios or something. AFV or something. Not America's Funny Some Videos, but something like that. I always get those two confused. Now let's walk through this way and then we'll enjoy the day. Here's the entrance to it. Back the doors is where we entered before. Over here was some sound stages that the tour of the backlot would go through. Fortunately, not in use anymore since the backlot tour has been shortened quite a bit. Over here would be more of the soundstage areas. What is this? Ooh, sorry, haven't seen him. Oh, wait. He was asking about a secret. I sent him to Hollywood and Vine. Don't know who you're talking about. Buzz Lightyear? Something? I don't know. Over here is Toy Story Midway Mania. Still popular attraction here at Disney's Hollywood Studios. Fast Pass area no longer in use since it's been upgraded to McMagic Plus. Over here it would still be some soundstage areas, but it's now a Captain Jack Sparrow, Legend of Captain Jack Sparrow, or something like that. It's a cute attraction. Over here we have One Man's Dream. Let's walk through this. Since it's still in Hollywood Studios, I think it was built in Hollywood Studios to deal with it. Disneyland Main Street USA, 90 States of Early Inspirations, Animation Table, Desk of Walt Elias Disney, Main Street USA, Auto Animatronics, Star of Auto Animatronics, Evolution of Costuming, Disneyland Castle. In real life, this would be very awesome to look at. Legend of Zorro, Costuming. This is where they would be filming the Walt Disney Epcot bit. You see Walt over there, and then you see TV. It's awesome. I think the TV would be up here. I should feel like filming him. Over here is a new Fantasyland area that you can see some of the stuff. And some other areas. And then you would watch a film about Walt Disney, the man, not the myth, and very legend. And over here you'd have the animation courtyard. You can draw some stuff and have fun. And over here is Disney Junior Live. Don't think this was Disney Junior the beginning. It was an awesome attraction that you can... Sorry about that. It was an awesome attraction you could just walk through and see. And over here is Hollywood and Vine. Awesome and lovely place to watch and eat and not watch. Watch people eat. You can watch people eat. House of Bajun. Don't do that. That's called rude and weird. But you can eat here, enjoy some atmosphere of Disney's House of Cities, but you'd want to eat inside when it's warm out. And that's it for Disney's Hollywood Studios from 1985. Oh, one quick last thing. What am I forgetting? One of the biggest things that was debuted here at Disney's Hollywood Studios in the early days. Why did I forget about this? It's called Indiana Jones Epic Stunt Spectacular. Wonderful. Wonderful attraction. That's still here. That still plays daily shows. I just have some incidents, but still... Still a great attraction to just watch and see. I think it's a lot better than Lightsmere Action. But it shouldn't be updated. You can't go into it, but I'll show you the exterior. Indiana Jones Stump Spectacular. Enjoy how they do scenes. Hear them talk and do some other scenes. Good attraction. You can sometimes hear it from the outside of the theme park. If you're parked in some specific areas, you might hear like a explosion and you'll say like, what is that? Is something going wrong in the theme park? No, don't think that something's going wrong. It's just how they do the show. Very safe, very good how they do the show. Only a couple of incidents has happened in the past, but unfortunately, only a couple in the past 25 years. Not a lot, but it's good. And that's where we call it a quits for this Indiana Jones Great Move Ride and Backlot Tour and all of the 25 years, or past 25 years, from 1985, while looking over the attractions that were here in 1989 of Disney's Hollywood Studios. I wish everyone a great day, great night. Have fun. Come on MC Magic, mcmagic.us. It's on the 1.7.5. So if you need to change it, you just do edit profile, just change the whatever recent thing you are on, probably 1.7.9, just bring it down to 1.7.5 and enjoy this theme park. Download some of it at mcmagic.us. Please comment and rate and review. Let me know if you'd like me to continue this series. I know some people want me to continue this series. I'll do it. And look for a companion video coming up, maybe after this video. I don't know. But it's their MC Magic server is having firework display over the hat. So I wish everyone a great day, great night, whatever time we're watching this. Enjoy and peace.